Hi there, I'm Courtney. This is Solavi Holistic, and you're watching another 2-minute meditation. Today we're gonna spend a couple of minutes just talking, and this specific topic is a little bit of a preview of a wonderful event that is coming up next Tuesday, February 16th at 1 o'clock, and it is the next installment of the ongoing workshop partnership that I have been doing with the Ellenville Public Library for the last few months. Tying it in with Valentine's Day, we'll be talking about mindfulness in relationships and how you can use the skills that you're building in this practice, in your meditation and your mindfulness practice, to strengthen and enhance all of your relationships. Because we're tying it in with Valentine's Day, there's going to be a little bit of an emphasis on romantic and intimate relationships. But these rules really do apply to work relationships, networking, family relationships, friendships of all types. So even if you find yourself unpartnered, or perhaps this isn't really relevant to your intimate and romantic relationships, these are skills that you can use in a lot of different ways. So when we meet next week, we're going to be talking about 3 major ways that mindfulness helps strengthen the bonds of our relationships. The first is through presence. We are better partners, we're better friends, we're better family members when we're actually present with the people that we're communicating with, that we're relating with. We can be more attentive, we can be more compassionate, we can just be giving more of ourselves to the people that we love when we're present. And so through meditation and mindfulness practice, you can work on being in your body, being in this moment. Another way that mindfulness really helps strengthen our relationships is in awareness, both of our emotional states and the emotional states of the people that we care about. Through mindfulness, through meditation, and through that personal exploration, we can start to identify our emotions earlier. We can find them in our body, and we can be thoughtful in the ways that we want to react to them. Through mindful awareness, we can be more aware of what's happening with the person that we're with in that moment, but also through practices like Tonglen and Metta, we can be more compassionate to the emotional states and to the experiences of people that we're relating with or in connection with. And then finally, kind of building off those first 2 points, mindfulness helps us communicate better. It helps us be thoughtful about our responses. It helps us start to navigate, you know, where is this response coming from? How do I want to address this concern instead of just kind of reactively, compulsively responding and maybe doing harm to the relationship because we weren't really being thoughtful or aware or compassionate in the way that we wanted to respond to a particular moment. We can also communicate better just by being present, just being in the moment with the person that we're communicating with. We're going to be able to be more just in that moment with them. So during the workshop next week, we're going to talk about all of these ideas with a lot more detail, and you're going to have an opportunity to, you know, bring your concerns or things that have worked for you, or just ask any questions that you may have. So send me a message or leave a comment if you're looking for the registration information or the Zoom link. We would love it if you could join us. Bring a friend, bring a partner. We'll see you soon. Bye.